Hey everyone, the name is Erik Thor and this is Erik versus the Stereotypes. And today we're talking about the INTJ Master Race Stereotype. So sometimes in memes and in popular culture today, we tend to paint the picture of INTJs as the superior personality type, the best personality type, the smartest personality type, the genius, the mastermind. So we get this picture in reality that most change and most powerful ideas and most systems and most solutions and visions in our society are the result of the work of INTJs. Now, I would like to tear this stereotype down, but it does have some truth to it. There are a lot of people out there that have been typed as INTJ, including Elon Musk, Jordan Peterson, Steve Jobs, and many, many more from this bubble of NTs. NTs represent innovators, so of course they might place a front runner race when it comes to bringing forward new ideas. Now, what reason do we have to look down on INTJs? What is the problem with the INTJ personality type? I would say the number one issue with INTJs is their inability to have fun and let go. INTJs struggle more than any other personality type to relax and take it easy. They are hardworking perfectionists. They are never satisfied with anything they do. They see everything as incorrect or in need of more work. They keep seeing flaws and issues with everything. They're constantly thinking ahead, looking at the future, looking at problems, looking at issues to be dealt with. They see the world as full of problems and issues. They are prone to a fatalism where they assume that the world is going under and only their ideas and the power of their ideas can stop it. And because this is such a massive, momentous project, it can consume every single minute of the INTJ's waking life, thinking about how can I deal with this crumbling reality around me, this problematic reality. And so what do INTJs have to work on? And I think what INTJs do when they hit an age of maturity in their life and when they start really coming into their own is when they start learning to relax and have fun. Break times to go out or to tune out, times to disconnect or to let go, times to relax some of your perfectionism. Other things I see in INTJs is learning to combine play with fun. So these two things, they are not necessarily antagonistic to one another. Work and play can go together, and you can find the joy and the fun in perfecting the world and improving on yourself and in constantly working hard for yourself. And you can learn to enjoy every moment of it and to see it as your version of kindergarten, your version of going out, your version of really doing something fun for yourself. So the thing you have to recognize is it fun? Is it something for myself? Is it something I do because I enjoy it? Or is it something that I do because I feel I have to? Have I put on this role of the serious person in the group that always has to be intense, serious, and working to improve everything? Or have I learned to laugh at issues and flaws and to find it amusing when people say things incorrectly and to find joy in correcting and thinking, okay, what can we do better? Okay, how can we get there from there? How can we improve from this situation? If you can learn to do this, you'll also get a lot more energy and motivation from your life, and you'll find a version of flow in which you can be original, you can be critical, and you can be hardworking and industrious and ambitious, and you can have goals and plans, and you can have rules and structure around you. But you can also have fun in the chaos and in the struggles that are naturally going to occur in your life. No matter what you do, you cannot get away from the fact that this is a chaotic world where not everything can be planned and accounted for, and where things are going to go wrong. And I think the reason why INTJs inevitably will mature and will learn to become more playful and easygoing is because at some point they learn to give up and to be humble in themselves and to say, okay, I know I cannot fix this. Okay, I know I cannot do everything here. Okay, I know I couldn't have anticipated this situation. okay, I understand that. I get that there was too much here, too many variables here at play and too many people to account for. So I can let go and I can learn to take responsibility only for the one thing that I can control, and that is myself. And then I can learn to accept and be one with what is happening around me. So that's my growth advice for INTJs. Do you agree with this video, or what do you feel INTJ's number one problem is? And how do you feel about this image of INTJs as masterminds? And what do you think as an INTJ, if you are an INTJ, what do you need to do to be a happier and more fulfilled person in what you do? And how do you keep your perfectionism from constantly discounting everything you do? Thanks for watching, and see you all in the next video.